Hello dear friends, good morning and welcome to Concrete Civil Concepts. And in this video we will be discussing our important topic of structural analysis, that is your influence line diagram. So this is the most important topic in structural analysis, and to understand the influence line diagram you must understand what is influence line. Okay, so the influence line diagram is a variation of your stress functions, and stress functions are anything like your shear force, bending moment, reaction, slope or deflection at a fixed section. When your 1 kilonewton or your concentrated unit load moves from one point or one end to another end. So this is your influence line diagram. Okay, now what is the application of this influence line diagram? That it used to calculate our live load. Okay, what is the maximum value of live load in any structure? So it can be calculated by using your influence line diagram. Okay, so this is a very useful topic to analyze our structure and to analyze our stress functions, that is your reaction, shear force, bending moment, slope or deflection. Okay, and this influence line diagram can be plotted for your both statically determinate beams as well as your indeterminate beams. Okay, so in this video we will be discussing our influence line diagram concept, and based on that we will plot our influence line diagram for reaction, then your bending moment, and then your shear force. Okay, so and based on this concept we will solve one numerical to find our shear force and bending moment value, okay, at a given section. So this is our question. Before we start our influence line diagram, so this is your influence line diagram. So as you know that influence line diagram is a variation of stress functions such as your reaction, shear force, bending moment, slope or deflection at a fixed section when your concentrated load moves from one end to another end. Okay, so this is the definition of your influence line diagram. And how we draw our reaction, your bending moment and shear force with the help of influence line diagram. Okay, so if we are having certain simply supported beam like this, one end of which is hinge support and another one is roller support, this is our A point, this is our B point, okay, and here this is our C point, okay, in between these two supports. So if we have to plot our reaction RA, the influence line diagram for RA, so you have to calculate or you have to plot the IND for reaction at A, bending moment at C, okay, and shear force at C. Okay, so you have to plot the influence line diagram for reaction at A and bending moment at C point and shear force at C point. Okay, so for reaction at A, what we will do, we will release our restraint and apply a unit displacement in the direction of release reaction. So we apply 1 kilonewton load in the positive direction of this release load, release support. Okay, so displacement. So this is how we plot, this is our beam and we release it and we provide 1 kilonewton unit load in a positive displacement direction. So this is our positive displacement direction and 1 kilonewton load is this. This is our 1 kilonewton. Okay, and after this we draw and we join this line with this straight line. Okay, as this is our statically determinate beam. So for statically determinate beam, our IND are only straight lines, and for indeterminate beams these are the combination of straight line or curved lines. Okay, so this is the way you plot your IRD for RA. This is the IRD for RA, reaction at A. Okay, this is our A point, this is our B point. Okay, now we have to plot our bending moment, ILD for bending moment at sea. So for bonding moment at sea, what we do? We release our bending moment. So how we release our bending moment at sea? We provide our internal hinge at sea. Okay. So we provide our internal hinge at sea, and it will have a influence line diagram of this triangular in shape. That is, your AC part is moving like this and CB part moving like this. So for your bending moment, influence line for bending moment at sea, your diagram will be, influence line diagram will be this. This is our bending moment influence line diagram. Okay. So this was our ordinate, and what is the height, or what is the ordinate? A upon L, L minus A is the ordinate for bending moment influence line diagram for bending moment at C. This is a C point, this is a A point, this is a B point. So this is the way you release your bending moment at a particular point where you ask, and here you provide internal hinge, and there you draw your influence line diagram. Okay, so this is the way you draw your or plot your influence line diagram for RA and influence line diagram for bending moment. Okay, now we have to draw or plot our influence line diagram for shear force. So to plot our shear force influence line diagram, what we do? We release our shear force at C point. And how we release our shear force? By inserting our slider roller, by providing roller. Okay, so by cut this beam and provide roller, slider, and the direction and the displacement in downward direction and the upward direction shows the influence line diagram for shear force. Okay, so how it is? This is the influence line diagram for C here. So the shape of the influence line diagram, this is A, this is B, this is our beam, and we provide what? We provide slider here. Okay, by cut the point where we ask to plot our influence line diagram. So we have to plot our influence line diagram for this point C. Then we cut this part and provide our roller, and one part of this goes to downward direction and another part goes to upward direction. So over this part AC will goes like this in downward direction and BC will go like this, and we are having a ordinate of 1 unit at the C point. So the shape of the shear force diagram is like this. This is our shape of the influence line diagram for shear force. So this is what, this is our influence line diagram for shear. This is our negative, this is our positive. Okay, so this was our positive. Okay, this is our positive. So this way you plot your influence line diagram for shear force at C. Okay, and what is this ordinate? This is our A upon L, and this is my L minus A upon L ordinate is this. Okay, so you just remember how you plot our influence line diagram for reactions, bending moment and shear force, and based on this you just solve many problems on influence line diagram. Okay, so based on this concept, and based on this concept we will solve one numerical, that we have to find the value of shear force and bending moment at the section. This is our section XX section, and this is our hinge support A, this is our roller support B, this is a simply supported beam, and which is a determinate beam, and 50 kilonewton load is acting at 1 meter distance from left end, and after that there is a 1 meter distance, and from 2 meter distance from left end UDL acts, okay, of span of 3 meters, 3 meters in length, and intensity 60 kilonewton per meter. And we have to find the value of shear force and bending moment at this XX section. Okay, so with the help of influence line diagram, we will see how we find the value of shear force and bending moment at this XX section. Okay, so this is our question. If take our A part, we are interested in influence line diagram for your shear force. Shear force at what? XX section. Okay, so for this XX section, we have to plot our influence line diagram. Okay, so what we do? We draw our, we know our how the influence line diagram of shear force comes like that. We provide what we release our shear force at this XX section and provide a slider or roller. So the shape of this influence line diagram is just like this is our downward portion, this is our upward portion, this is our this part, this is our negative, this is our positive here. Okay, and these are the ordinates, like this is our AF1L, this is my L minus AF1L. This is the way you plot our influence line diagram. Now plot this diagram here in broader way, like this is our downward position, this is our maximum, this is our position. Okay, now we are having, this is our A part, this is our C value here, and this is our D value. Now this is our E value is here, okay, and this is our B value. Okay, now we have to find our coordinate for this C, for this D, and for this E. Okay, that is your YE here. If I say it is YE, if I say it is YC here, if I say it is YD here. Okay, and this is overall, this is what? 1. This is overall is 1. This is 1 unit. Okay, this is A upon L, this is L minus A upon L. So A upon L plus L minus A upon L is equal to what? 1. Okay, so the summation should be 1. Now we have to find our coordinate YC, YD, and YE. And based on that, we find the value of shear force at this XX section. This is our XX section. Okay. Now, how we do? You just remove this. Okay. Now, what is the value of YC here? So, this is our 1 meter. This is our 1 meter here. And total is 2 plus 2 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1. It is 3 or 4. 7 meter span total, and this is our 1. So what is the ordinate of this YC is 1 by 7. So the ordinate of YC is 1 by 7. Okay. Now what is the ordinate for YD here? This is our 1 meter. This is our 1 meter. So this is our 2 meter, and total span is 7. So the ordinate of YD is what? 2 by 7. Okay, now similarly we have to find the ordinate of YE here. So this is a 2 meter distance and total span is 7 meters. So the ordinate of YE is 2 by 7 here. Okay, and this is 1, we know. Okay, now what is the ordinate of this? Okay, so this is what? This is our 3 meters. 1 meter, 1 meter, 1 meter, 3. Total is 3 meter and total span is 7. So this ordinate is 3 by 7 here. Okay. And what is the ordinate of this part? This is our 2 into 4. So total is 4. So it is a 4 by 7 here. Okay. So these are the ordinates. As this is my L minus A upon L. This is your what? L minus A upon L here. What is the value of L? It is 7 minus A value is 3 meter. From left hand, 1 plus 1 plus 1, it is 3 meter. This is our A value. This is nothing but this is our A value. Okay. So this is my 3 upon L is 7 here. So it is what? 4 upon 7. So it is our 4 upon 7. You just check it. Okay. Now what is our 3 by 7? It is what? This is our A upon L. So A value is what? 3 meter from left hand, and total span is 7 meter. So by this way you plot your shear force, ILD of shear force. Okay, ILD for shear force at XX section. Okay, now you just have to calculate the shear force value at XX section. Okay, so what you do, you just calculate it with the help of your influence line diagram and whatever the load coming and load, this is your 50 kilonewton multiply by your ordinate of influence line diagram at this C point. So this is C point is 50 kilonewton into your YC. So YC is negative, this position is in negative and this is positive here. Okay, so what is this? This is our 50 kilonewton multiply by our YC value here. Okay, so plus what is this? This is our 60 kilonewton per meter intensity. UDL is there, and for that you have to solve your this part. This is your trapezium here. What is this? This is your trapezium here. Okay. So the area of trapezium is 1 upon 2 into sum of parallel sides into distance. So it is your 1 meter here. What is this? This is 1 meter D to E. This is your 1 meter. So by putting this is the value of what? 60. It is the intensity of UDL into area. Whatever the intensity load into your area of this influence line diagram part. So area of this trapezium is what? 1 upon 2. Into what? Sum of parallel sides. So sum of parallel sides means this is our YD, this is our 3/7. So it is your 2/7 and 3/7. Okay. With negative sign because it is in negative direction. So we just write YD plus if this is your YXX. If I consider this is your YXX. Okay. So plus YXX into your distance between these two. So the distance between these two is 1 meter. So half into sum of parallel sides into distance. So it is 1 meter. So this is our calculation for shear force. Okay. So I write here again 60 multiplied by 1 upon 2 into YD plus YXX multiplied by 1 meter. Okay. So this is the this part and we are having another part here. Okay. So this is again your 60 kilonewton per meter intensity multiplied. This is again your trapezium part. Okay. So we have to write our area. So what is the intensity of load? It is your plus 60 multiplied by area of trapezium is half into sum of parallel sides 4/7 plus 2/7 into distance. So distance of this DE is 2 meter here. This is 2 meter, this is 2 meter in the question. 2 meter and 2 meter. So what is this? 60. So half into what? Half into what? 4/7 plus this is what? 2/7 multiplied by width, it is 2 meter. Okay. So by putting the value of YD and YXX here, so YD value is 2/7 with negative sign because it is in negative position. So minus 2/7 we have to put here. What is the value is? Minus 2/7. And what is the YXX value is? YXX value is 3/7. So minus 3/7. Okay. So you just solve this equation. Everything is known. And we just find the value of shear force at this XX section. Okay. So you just solve this part. Shear force at XX section. And the value of shear force for this XX section is like your 160 upon 7 kilonewton. Like it is your 160 upon 7 kilonewton. So this is the way you plot your influence line diagram. And you calculate your value of at any section in your determinate B. Okay, with the help of influence line diagram. Okay. Now our B part is we have to draw our influence line diagram for this bending moment at this XX section. Now we know our the shape of the influence line diagram for bending moment is it triangular in nature. Like I just draw it. Okay, so influence line diagram for bending moment at XX. Okay, so you know we have to release our bending moment. To draw our influence line diagram for bending moment, we have to release our bending moment at this XX section by inserting or by providing pin joint or by providing pin. Okay, so we are having a shape of bending moment like this. This is our XX position and the ordinate of this is A upon L, L minus A. Okay, so this is our ordinate and this is our A point. This is our XX section here. This is our B point. So you just solve the value of A. What is the value of A? A value is left hand. From left hand it is 1 meter, 1 meter, 1 meter, 3 meter. So it is your 3 meter. L value is total span is 7 meter into L minus A is 7 minus 3. So you just solve here. 7 minus 3 is 4. 4 is 12 by 7. The ordinate of this is 12 by 7 here. Okay. So it is positive in nature. Okay. So this is positive. Whole diagram is positive. And what is the ordinate for this? This is your C point here. Okay. And this is your D point here. Okay. Now this is your E point here. Okay. So this is what? This is your YC here. This is your YD here. And this is your YE here. Okay. So you just calculate the ordinates for YC, YD and YE. So the ordinate of YC, how you calculate the ordinate of YC? This is your 1 meter here, this is your 1 meter here, this is your 1 meter here, this is your 2 meter and 2 meter. Okay, so you have the value of 12 by 7 of this. So you take your triangle this, okay, and this smaller triangle, you have to find the value of YC here. So this similar triangle, from similar triangles, from similar triangles we know YC upon what? 1 is equal to maximum, bigger triangle is 12 by 7 upon what? This is 1 plus 1 plus 1 is 3. So the ordinate of YC is 4, 4 by 7. It is your 4 by 7. Okay. Now what is the ordinate for YD is? So same, but now taking this triangle here, okay, you have the value of YC is what? Your 4 by 7 and you have the value, you have to calculate our YD value. So YD upon 2, YD upon 2 is equal to what? Your 4 by 7 upon what? 1. Okay, so our YD value is, this implies that YD value is 8 by 7. Okay, so you just calculate the value or ordinates, okay, and YC, YD, and you just also calculate the value for this YE ordinate. Bigger value is 12 by 7 upon 4, so it is your YE upon 2 is equal to what? 12 by 7 upon what? 2 into 2, 4, so it is 4, so it is 6 times 2 times, 3 times, so it is YE. So what is the value of YE here? YE is 6 by 7. Okay. So YE value is 6 by 7. You just write with the help of similar triangle is 6 by 7. Yes. So by this way you just find the ordinates for YD, YE and YC and write the equation for bending moment. By simply multiplying your, by applying your influence line diagram application, that is your load is 50 into your portion is YC is what? 4 by 7. So bending moment at, so if I write the equation, so bending moment at XX section here is what? 50 multiplied by YC. YC is positive in nature. So YC, okay, so all are in positive plus. Now what is this magnitude? It is your intensity of 60 kilonewton per meter and the area is this diagram, this area and this area you have to consider. So this is a trapezium, 1 upon 2 sum of parallel sides, this is YD plus this YXX. Okay, similarly, and the distance between this is 1 meter, and similarly for this 60 plus 60 into 1 by 2 sum of parallel sides into multiplying distance is 2 meter. Okay, So you just write the value for this, that 15 into yc plus 60 into 1 upon 2 into ordinate of this yd here plus the ordinate of this. This is yx x1 say plus this trapezium area 1 upon 2 into what? Yx x2 say plus what? Ye. Okay. So you just you have already calculated your ordinate values ye, yxx, so yc. Now putting all the values and you just get your results. Okay. So bending moment at xx here is your, you are having a value of 268.57 kilonewton meter. Okay. So by this way you just solve so many questions on influence line diagram, and we will discuss Muller-Breslau principle also in our later videos. So do subscribe. Thank you so much.